bookmark design. This lesson is on designing bookmarks with Adobe InDesign. First, we will start with a new document. Go to the File menu, New, Document. Set the width to 2 inches and the height to 6 inches. Make sure the orientation is vertical. Set your margins to a minimum of 1/8 inch. Now click the More Options button and set the bleed to 1/8 of an inch as well. Click OK. I plan to show you a couple of ways to place images with InDesign. So add 2 pages to the layout. Go to the Layout menu, Pages, Insert Pages. Set the number to 2. The document still has facing pages turned on, leaving no room for bleed between the 2 pages on this spread. To fix this, go to the File menu, Document Setup, and uncheck Facing Pages. That setting is typically only used for booklets and catalogs. Now the 3 pages are all on separate spreads. Now to place your image. For this tutorial, I've already cropped and sized my images to the proper size and resolution. For a bookmark, that size will be 2.25 by 6.25. This size is determined by adding the trim size to the amount of bleed on both sides, left and right, or top and bottom, to give us the overall dimension of the artwork if it bleeds. Now for several ways to place images in InDesign. First, the click-drag method. Go to the File menu, Place, select your file, then click and hold down the mouse button and drag the box out to the proper size. Note the picture box shows a proportional preview that scales up and down as you drag. Second, the click-to-place method. Since I know these images are sized properly, I can just go to the File menu, Place, select your file, click where I want the image, and pow, there it is, at the right size. The last way I will show you in this tutorial is if you have a picture box already drawn, for example from a master page. You select the picture box and use the Place command again. I'll draw a box and use the measurement palette to size and align it on the page. You can see here I have the image box sized properly, but it is aligned at 0, 0. It needs to be aligned at -0.125, -0.125. Now place the image. Next we'll get to some design. A basic bookmark with a quote. With a basic bookmark, find a nice quote and type it into a text block. Add a phone number and a logo. I already have this prepared and we'll cut and paste it in. Arrange the type and logo how you prefer. Make any adjustments as needed. Now create another rectangle. Fill it with white and set the opacity to 50%. Now you will want to have it behind the type, so select the white box and the background and go to the Object menu, Arrange, Send to Back. I'll adjust this transparent box and then round the corners on the box to give it a little polish. Object menu, Corner Options. Effect to Rounded. Preview. Okay. Next, to show you another trick, I will convert the quote marks to artwork. Go to the Type menu, Create Outlines. Then proceed to the Object menu, Paths, Release Compound Path, to split the artwork up. Then group the individual marks together. Command G is the shortcut for that. It's also under the Object menu, Group. Now position the quote marks where you want them. Now that you have all the elements in place, change the colors to something that goes well with your background. Here's a quick eyedropper trick to copy the style of the type above and format the phone number with the same attributes. I think I want the size a bit larger for the number. Just a quick adjustment in the font palette. You can also use a bookmark as a coupon. It is yet another way to use these small marketing gems. Use the same format as we have here and add a promotional code at the bottom. In conclusion, you now have some simple design ideas for any bookmark project. At this point, don't be afraid to play with the settings and images and see what you can create on your own. The more you get in there and play, the easier it gets. Keep designing!